Hey y'all, I'm Kelly Bannon, and we are catching up with Tenille Arts about her brand new album, Girl to Girl. We're chatting about bedazzled looks from her tour with Lady A, some words to live by, as well as a song that I think is a serious contender for Song of the Year. I would love to pick up with, just because, you know, you've just had a really fun tour rap with Lady A, and we were talking about these amazing Dolce & Gabbana jeans that you were saying and kind of inspired the whole tour look. Like, I want to hear about how you dream up those kinds of aspects of stage and wardrobe for tour and kind of like for your artist identity.
Yeah, I mean, I've always dreamed of being able to go on tour and like putting together those looks and everything, and my stylist is incredible, and thankfully, you know, she has those connections with people like Dolce & Gabbana, because I actually just found those jeans on a post and I sent them to her and I was like, these are incredible. Is it possible to get these? Because I think we could like really just like go to town on everything else and make it kind of fit that look. So we got those pants, which was incredible.
Will you describe them?
So there, first of all, there's safety pins all over them. There's jewels and pearls just like covering the entire front of the pants, and they're just so cool, so much detail. And that's what led to, you know, there's other shorts that we ended up taking and getting the seamstress to like do that to them, like have the jewels and everything all over them. So I had multiple looks that kind of just like led back to that Dolce & Gabbana look. So it was really fun to play around for the first time on my first major tour and just get to like make those looks and have them all like, this is my tour wardrobe. You know?
That's cool. That's like totally part of the dream. I'm like, when I'm, you know, thinking about what those stages would be like, I'm totally thinking about wardrobe as an avenue for storytelling too. Like, yeah. And especially I think as women, it's like, oh, that's so much fun to play with. I mean, I was gonna wrap this interview with Growing Old Young, because I mean, before you walked in here today, I was like, there is a Song of the Year like level song on this record. Like, how the hell does that song happen? And what, I mean, it is just stunning.
Thank you. I mean, it's just, I think there are so many things in our lives that make us feel like we had to grow up a little too fast. And you know, whether that's being bullied at school, just not accepting yourself, you know, trouble at home with your parents, or addiction, substance abuse. It's like all of those things. I'm like, these are things that go on in like the everyday home that people never touch on in country music. I'm like, it's like this thing. And I say in the song, like, sweep it under the carpet. That's what everybody does all the time. And, you know, I've seen my parents' generation do that. That was kind of a thing. It was just, you know, we don't want to talk about it. We don't want to talk about mental health. We don't want to go there because mm-hmm. that's too deep for an everyday conversation. But I think everybody, just even over the last year on social media, people have been opening up, sharing what they've been through. And to me, until I started to do that myself, I thought, I'm so alone. You know, mm-hmm. I don't want to put this out there because I don't think anybody has been through what I've been through. And the second I started talking about things and opening up about anxiety and like all of these things, it was like everybody I know has been through the same things. And it immediately makes you feel less alone. And it makes you feel like you can go on about your day and not be like, not feel like you've got this big secret or this big like burden on your heart and weight on your shoulders. You know, you can open up and share things with people. And especially writing this song with two men, that was to me the most surprising thing, was that these guys wanted to sit in this room and open up about that. Like, what an incredible just nod to, you know, just telling men to open up.
Well, we started with the very last song on the track, but let's go to the first. I want to hear about what it's like to put out Back Then, Right Now, after the enormous success of Somebody Like That. Is it different this time around?
I mean, it definitely feels different. It feels like there's like a lot of pressure on the second song, you
really?
Know, that you put out after a big song like that. And for me, I was like, I didn't know what that song was gonna be. This was one of the last songs that was written for the record. And I just remember being like, you know, I had been actually sent the song. I was sent like pretty much a finished song, and I loved the chorus, but I wanted to go back in and like, you know, kind of make those verses really my own. And so I went back into the writing room And I was like, this is the most perfect song for where we are right now, because everybody just wants to get back to simpler times, you know? Mm-hmm. And for me, you know, even in the second chorus or second verse, we mention my little yellow Pontiac. And that was the car that I drove around my hometown and drove all the way to Nashville and still drove up until like a couple months ago. And so that was like...
He's riding around in that little yellow Pontiac now.
It's, I still have it. It's just parked. I don't want to be driving that thing anymore. People literally would be like, oh, there's Tenille. But yeah, I mentioned all of those things. And just going back to my hometown and just when things didn't seem so heavy. And I think coming out of a pandemic, it's like we even touch on it in the music video. It's like people coming out of their homes for the first time and just wanting to have a good time and get back to it, get back to live music, all of that. So we just tried to put that all in the song.
A couple of my favorites are produced by Nathan Chapman, Growing Old Young, which we've talked about, but also the title track, Girl to Girl. What, tell me a little bit about that relationship.
So Nathan is incredible. I've obviously looked up to him, and he did that incredible Taylor album. And when we went in to record, I was like, a lot of these songs that I wanted him to work on felt like some of that early Taylor stuff. And so I was like, I think he's going to be the perfect fit for this. We were actually in the studio and in the vocal booth that she recorded all that stuff with Nathan. So it was really cool just to, you know, grow up watching Taylor, you know, take off and knowing like this guy was... Both of them were so unknown and they both just like took a chance on each other. And I think that's such a beautiful relationship. And, you know, Nathan doesn't just work with anybody. So I just felt very blessed that he was like, I love these songs. I want to work on this. And we pretty much did all of the vocals that day. Like I didn't go back in and like re-sing anything. He was so great. It was the first time that somebody had said to me, like, sing the verses like you're just telling a story. Don't worry about being perfect. Just like sing the verses like you're telling the story. When you get to the chorus, sing like you're a singer. And that was...
I like that tweak on that idea.
Yeah, that to me was the first time I'd ever heard that. And to me, it just made, especially growing old young, I was like, dang, I sound like I'm about to be in tears, which I was. And that was like so cool for me to actually be able to listen back and like feel my own emotion in the song. So now I try to take that into everything. So basically all of the songs on this record were like, I wanted to write them. I felt like I was writing songs that I wish I had when I was 15, 16 years old, mm-hmm. like going through those things. And Girl to Girl, it's, you know, being the title of the album is more about like the letter to my younger self, the letter to the fans, the letter to everybody. And this specific song is more like, girl, don't go there. I've been there, done that. This is, you know, it's gonna hurt. And it's, you never want to hear that advice from like your parents. You know, you can, they can preach all day long about how high school was, you know, just high school. But when you're in that moment and you are walking those halls, you like, you feel like it's everything. No matter what people tell you, you feel like it's everything. And so I wanted to write this album from a point of view where I'm like, I want to be your big sister and tell you, hey, for real, this is just high school. You know, I've been there, done that, thought I was going to marry my high school sweetheart. And it's like, no, turns out like there are incredible people in this world that you're going to meet and you're going to go do incredible things. Like, and if you do marry a high school sweetheart, that's great. Like, I'm not trying to say that that can't happen, but it's just, you know, it is that one of those things that you don't have to focus on that. And, you know, bigger and better things are going to come in your life.